The attack took place in Dogogawa village of this council, which led to the killing of his police orderly. The chairman, Takum Local Government Area of Taraba State, Shiban Tikari, narrowly escaped death early Saturday morning as armed military opened fire on his vehicle. According to Daily Post, the attack took place in Dogogawa village of the council, which led to the killing of his police orderly. The deceased policeman is of the 67 Mobile Police Squadron located in the council. In another related development, police in the Wukari Council of the state were reported to have foiled a kidnap attempt in Choku village of the council, with a heavy exchange of gunshots between them and the bandits. Takum and Wukari councils, located in the state's southern geopolitical zone, have been under severe attack in recent time. Confirming the attack, Tikari said the militias, in their number, launched an attack on the convoy while on his way to Takum. He called for more redeployment of security personnel to the area. A senior police officer from the area, who also confirmed the incident to our correspondent, could not understand why hoodlums terrorizing the neighborhood have decided to make police their targets. The police officer, who identified logistics as one of the challenges making it possible for the hoodlums to be tracked down, urged the state government to adhere to its promise by collaborating with the force, especially in the areas of logistics. The council chairman, Daniel Adi, said the attackers, who stormed the community at about 3 a.m., were repelled by the police. At about 3 a.m., while the police were at their duty post, unknown gunmen came around and started shooting sporadically, he said. Displaying the exploded bullets, he said it was just by the grace of God and the experience of the police that made it impossible for the bandits to succeed. While applauding the police for their brave act, he said government at all levels should, as a matter of urgency, come to the council's aid by drafting more operatives to the area. Well, this is really serious. Bandits now attack police officers at their duty post. I don't know the reason why they're attacking them, but I know there'll surely be a reason behind the hoodlums going to attack the policemen at their duty post. But we thank God for his grace that he did not allow the experience of the police to go in vain. It made it impossible for the bandits to succeed over the policemen at their duty post. We thank God for the brave mind the Lord has given them, so that they could tackle what really happened as at that time. Well, let's see people's reaction and know their thoughts about what just happened. Ofele said, "I wish our police can one day turn against our politicians. Shoot all of them once. Nigeria will be better." Wow. This person really wants the policemen to turn against the politicians and shoot them all and just get rid of them at once. But is that really the solution to what's really happening now? Shooting the politician, would that solve the problem we are facing now? We are facing the problem of which bandits now attack the policemen at their duty post. Now we are now saying the policemen should go against the politicians and you know, fire them and just eliminate all of them? Would that really solve the problem? Would that really help us? Well, let's see another person's thoughts about this. Mercy Andrew said, bandits, herdsmen, more are yet to come. God protect ordinary people in Nigeria. Well, this person is saying bandits, herdsmen are just a preamble to what is yet to come. That more and more of more experience will showcase in Nigeria, of which we will complain even more than the one we are facing now. Is it that the politicians are not doing their responsibilities they ought to do for the policemen? Is it that they are not giving them enough support? Is it that the politicians are not working in line with the policemen? Because the way people are now reading this incident, they want the policemen to go against the politicians and just, you know, eliminate all of them. Well, I don't know, or I don't think that's the next step of action. I think the policemen, if probably the politicians or the government in question are not in support of them, or are not giving them enough support of which they are in need of, maybe they should just, you know, write to them, write on their behalf and say they need more support from them and see their response, instead of just wishing the policemen to just turn against the politicians and just fire all of them and just eliminate them at once. Well, we are still in Nigeria. I pray the Lord will help us. And also, if bandits thought they have been offended by the government, or perhaps some police might have offended them, I think they shouldn't have just fired the innocent policemen, of which they are innocent and they know nothing about what's going on. They should just leave the innocent Nigerians and look for the corrupt leaders of the three arms of government and their families, perhaps. They should just show their power to the people who are responsible, you know, for what they are going through, and not to just fire policemen, fire innocent civilians that are just, you know, coincidentally at the place where the incident happened. Please, I want you to share your comments with us. Thank you guys for listening. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel if you have not, and I will see you on the other news. Bye for now.